How's it going, guys? Welcome back to the channel where we talk about filmmaking, photography, iPad Pro related content and tech. My name is Ken and today I'll be sharing with you guys my first impression of Anduhr's TP65 video fluid head that I picked up for about 200 ringgit. For those of you video shooters that are interested to know more about a budget panning fluid video head, then this could be a video for you guys. However, this is just a first impression video. As always, I will be sure to follow up with a full review of this product sometime in the future. So without wasting any more time, let's dive right into the unboxing and setting this thing up for the very first time. So, taking a quick look at Anduhr's TP65 fluid video head, it comes with a retractable handle, which I believe is used to help with the panning motion without actually holding the camera, and a screw to mount it to the video head. The quick release plate that comes in a box is the longer version, and you can easily remove the plate with this spring mechanism. Tighten the screw right here, and you get to lock the quick release plate in place. The quick release plate also comes in various screw threads. I believe it's a 3/8 as well as a 1/4 inch screw thread. And here is the tilt up and down movement of the fluid head. Pretty smooth just by tilting it up and down right here. The panning left and right is at the bottom, which we need to mount it on a tripod in order for it to work, which we will get into it in just a second. So to be honest, the TP65 video head looks like an imitation from Manfrotto's version. I believe it's called the MVH500AH Quick Release Fluid Video Head. So I believe this thing right here is going to solve a problem that I've always been facing, that is getting consistent left to right panning shots. If you've been following the channel, I've been throwing in a lot of B-roll scenes with lots of smooth panning shots from left to right, using my Benroll tripod right here that uses a regular ball head. Since this is a twist to lock tripod type, so I utilize this twist lock mechanism to simulate a left to right panning shot, and the downside is I would have to practice a couple of times in order to get a really smooth panning motion. And so I thought to myself, it is finally time to upgrade to a proper video head. In case you are looking for an ultra compact tripod, I'm also looking into making a full review of the Benroll IS05 tripod sometime in the future. And so I'll be sure to leave a link in the card above whenever this video is out. Anyways, back to the video head, I first installed the handle of the fluid head. Since I am right-handed, so the handle will be on the right-hand side. I then align the teeth of the handle and tighten it with the provided screw. And for the next 10 to 15 minutes or so, I then struggled a whole bunch just to remove the ball head from this Benroll tripod. And so eventually I resorted to just mounting the entire fluid head with a quick release plate at the bottom. Slide the entire setup on the Benroll tripod's quick release mount, tighten it and call it a day. On the longer quick release plate that comes in a box, I've attached my set of quick release plates in order to easily match all the other mounting systems of my choice. So after placing the camera on the video head, I have to say that I am pretty impressed with the outcome of a smooth panning shot. Now that I'm able to recreate the same smooth panning motions over and over again, this would probably help with my video workflow. This video head also allows for smooth horizontal tilting up and down for these kind of cinematic shots. Overall, I'm pretty satisfied with the product right here. The panning is really, really smooth as you can see from the footage. You get to also increase the resistance on the panning axis. There's also a safety spring that ensures your camera springs back to the original position like this, if the camera is not too heavy. And of course, more detailed explanation of all the features there is to know of Anduhr's TP65 fluid video head sometime in the future. So my impression, for about half the full price of Manfrotto's fluid head, it is pretty impressive. According to some of the videos that I've watched, most of them say that it is well worth the price, especially if you are a beginner just starting out. So as usual, I'm looking forward to make a full review in a couple of months after extensively using it for everything I do here in the studio. So be sure to be subscribed to the channel to get notified the moment this video is available. And that's basically it for this short video. Hope you all find this video insightful. If you have any questions at all, feel free to drop me a comment down below. Anything you guys want me to check or test out, I'll be sure to get back to you guys as soon as possible. like the video if you actually enjoyed it, and subscribe if you haven't already. As always, thank you all so, so much for tuning in. I'll catch you all in the next video. Stay safe, peace out, and bye bye.